Last video, we learned how to play animations with a very simple code, animator play. But they are loop animations only. Today, let's see how to play a non-loop animation, like attack animation, and how to play another animation after animation attack is ended. How to calculate time length of an animation to spawn spell or projectile right after. And how to fix animation go under the floor. A very common issue that many people ask me recently. Last video, we learned how to play animations of player. But these are loop animations only. It is repeated endlessly. Let's create some non-loop animation today. Open our player package. To create an animation, just select multi-images and drop them into hierarchy. Rename it attack for attack animation. You can delete this object, we don't need it. After animation attack is created, add it into player animator. Just hold and drop it into. Make it a non-loop animation, because it is played one time only. After animation attack is ended, you can make it back to animation idle automatically by using make transition. Open player controller script. First, let's create a variable to tell that a non-loop animation is playing. It will be true or false only. And make it public to watch its value easily on editor. Now go to function playing animation. To play an animation, simply just call this function with animation name. Let's duplicate it to create a function to play non-loop animation. While a non-loop animation is playing, all other animations will be disabled. Or you can say that loop animations can be played only if don't have any non-loop animation playing. To play a non-loop animation, simply just call this function. Let's create a new void function, animation attack. First, we have to stop all playing animations by changing value of isNonLoopAnimation to true. And to play animation attack, we call playing non-loop animation. Animation name is attack. On keyboard controller, let's add a button to do player attack here. Use input get key down. And you can use any button you like. Whenever button T is pressed, let's make player do attack. Press play to test it. Player can walk or jump normally. Now press button T to play non-loop animation attack. Animation attack is played. Variable isNonLoopAnimation is true now and did not turn off yet. So you cannot play other animations. After animation attack is ended, let's turn isNonLoopAnimation to false. So you can play other animations, walk or run again. I don't know when animation attack is ended, let's just wait for 1 second. Wait event, always use with yield return new. And yield return new must be inside IEnumerator function. After animation attack ended, let's reset variable isNonLoopAnimation back to false value so you can play other animations. We need to use start coroutine to call an IEnumerator event instead. Control S, save your script. Press button attack and watch variable isNonLoopAnimation. Its value is true. After 1 second, it back to false again. Player can walk or jump normally after animation attack now. When a non-loop animation is playing, we have to wait until that animation is ended to reset isNonLoopAnimation to false to play other animations. If it waits 1 or 2 seconds, it will take very long to reset other animations. Let's calculate the exact duration of the animation that we have to wait. Name this function is prepare non-loop animation. With input as name of non-loop animation will play. Replace animation name into to play that animation. Now we have to calculate how long this animation will be ended. When an animation is called, it will be played at the end of frame. So we have to wait until end of frame for new animation is updated. Then we can get information of new animation that is playing. We already have component animator here. We can get current animation information from this component animator. It requires current layer index of animator. Our player animator has one layer only. If you have many layers, second layer will have index 1, and the first layer will have index 0. Our player animator has one layer only. Index will be 0. Now you can get any information from this current animation. To make sure our non-loop animation is playing, check the name of current animation. You can get duration of our animation now. It will be the length of time this animation is played. You know exactly the time when this non-loop animation is ended now. Add time in too, to play other animations after non-loop animation ended. If it's not our non-loop animation playing, just turn is non-loop animation equals false right away. Instead wait for 0 second, you can use null to skip the wait event. To play any non-loop animation, we call this function now. Example, create new void event for player attack. To play animation attack, call event prepare non-loop animation. On button attack, call event player attack. When you run the game now, press button attack. After animation attack is ended, other animations can be played right away. Next video, we will create bullet or projectile after you press button attack. In last video, many people have issue that animation go under the floor because you don't follow tutorial carefully. To fix it, select your sprite. Go to Sprite Editor. You can see your pivot is at center. It means player position will be at center. This is the reason, make animation go under the floor. In last video, I mentioned that you need to set this pivot to character feet. To do that, select image. Change its pivot to bottom. You can see the pivot at character feet now. Do the same for all these images. Another way to change this pivot faster is on slice menu, select grid by cell count. Our sprite have 1 row and 5 columns. Then select pivot at bottom. Then click slice. All pivot are reset to bottom. Click apply. Now you can press play and the issue will be fixed. In some version of Unity Editor, you must delete old animation to make new one after you fix pivot already. Create animation attack again, as you did earlier. The issue must be fixed now. Don't forget to subscribe my channel to save this video. Thank you for watching, and see you in next video.